world today, we have some problems with trust. We don't know who to trust, how much to trust them, when to trust them. Figuring out how to trust people, though, is nothing particularly new. We've always had to do that. But what happens when you throw machines into the mix? We've learned by now to take the words of politicians with a grain of salt. But what about the words coming from Siri or Alexa? When should we be trusting them? This isn't a niche issue either. We all live in a world where more and more decisions are influenced in some way by machine learning. But here's the problem. The people coming in contact with these tools every day don't have the basis for figuring out when and how to trust them. At the same time, the engineers building these things don't have the basis to foresee and prevent misaligned trust. My name is Harini Suresh, and I'm currently a third-year PhD student in computer science at MIT. In my field, there's been a lot of focus recently on building better models and on figuring out how to prevent those models from encoding harmful stereotypes. And this is really important work. But here's what's worrying me. Even if we have perfect models, we can still misinterpret and misuse them. In other words, any model can lead to harmful consequences if people trust it in the wrong ways. And it turns out that often they do. These issues of trust are what I'm studying in my research, and they're particularly tricky because they arise outside of the typical machine learning development pipeline. The core problem is that these systems usually don't operate all on their own. They're placed in the hands of human decision makers who take the model's output, interpret it, and then go on to make the actual final decision. So if those people don't understand the limitations of a model, when it should be trusted, and when it should not, there's no guarantee that these systems will actually deliver their intended positive impact. At MIT, I've been running two studies to investigate exactly this. In the first study, we're looking at machine learning in the clinical context. We're giving hundreds of radiologists chest x-rays, something that they do every day in their normal workflow. And we're also giving them findings and diagnostic recommendations about each case. And we're asking the question, do doctors act on these recommendations in the same way when the recommendation comes from a fellow radiologist versus from a machine learning system? This really matters, as machine learning-based tools just like this are being rolled out in hospitals across the country. And if doctors are behaving in unexpected ways, we need to know that, and we need to figure out how to account for it. In another study, we're asking similar questions, but with respect to the general public. Because as these tools become more commonplace, they won't just be used by domain experts, but all kinds of people with all kinds of backgrounds will be relying on them. Both of these studies are currently under peer review, so I can't talk about them in a ton of detail, but one of the really important, startling trends that we found is that people overwhelmingly are willing to go against their own knowledge and intuition if a machine learning system tells them to. Talk about trust issues. So here's the thing. People are good at certain tasks, and models are good at certain tasks. The strengths and weaknesses of people and models, though, the places where they mess up, are usually different. These systems need to be improving performance where people are lacking, but not worsening performance when people would otherwise act correctly. Right now, though, we're not there, and it's already leading to harmful consequences. So in my work, I'm trying to expand the machine learning pipeline to include the complicated processes of human interaction. Maybe this will mean we need to build more user-friendly interfaces or more understandable models or something different. Honestly, we need more research in this area to know. And part of what I really want to do is motivate that research. Sometimes that's hard, because often computer scientists don't want to mess with actual humans. This isn't true across the board, of course. There are some really awesome researchers at MIT and elsewhere working on paving the way for this type of interdisciplinary work. But it needs to happen on a much larger scale. And we need more than just computer science research. We have a big gap in civic education. Regular people need to know what this machine learning tool that they're using is doing and when they should listen to it and when they should really rely on their own judgment. That's why I'm working with my colleague Natalie Lau to educate the public in a way that describes what machine learning can do, but also how to understand its limitations. We're currently building a set of short, engaging videos about machine learning featuring easy-to-understand illustrations, and some of these are already available, freely available on YouTube. You can just search ML tidbits to find them. A preliminary study that we ran showed that these videos increased knowledge of machine learning and willingness to engage in civic discussions about these technologies, especially for those people who came in knowing very little. So, look, machine learning can hugely benefit society, but our systems have got to be able to work with people to improve their behavior and not to make it worse. At MIT, we've been working on figuring out how to build systems that do this and also how to educate the public. But we all can and need to demand accountability from the companies building and using these systems because it's happening in healthcare, in hiring, in criminal justice, and it affects us all. So I'm really grateful for the chance to work on these problems on and off the MIT campus in an effort to make a better world. Thank you.